Concrete is widely used for roadway paving all around the world. But can you pour a concrete pavement with no rebars, formwork, and expansion joints? Traditional answer would be no. But what if I told you that you can, and that would not be a sloppy do-it-yourself project? Rather, it would be an industrial-grade concrete that is capable of withstanding tremendous pressure and heavy loads. Today, we will talk about a very special type of concrete, a type that most people never heard of. Concrete that does not look like traditional concrete, and that is not even placed like traditional concrete. Yet, it is much more durable and robust than traditional concrete. It is called roller compacted concrete, or simply RCC. Today, I will explain to you what RCC is, how it differs from traditional concrete, and we will look at the placement process and its history. So, what is roller compacted concrete, and why is it so different from traditional concrete? For us to answer this question, we need to understand what the fundamental difference between traditional concrete and RCC is. Let us look at how traditional concrete is mixed. Concrete consists of four main ingredients: water, cement, sand, and rock, which are called fine and coarse aggregates. Together, concrete, those four ingredients are mixed in proportions. Typical rule of thumb is to use 1-to-3 ratio, which means for 1 unit of cement, 2 units of sand and 3 units of rock are added. Water is added into the mix by eye judging to get a desired consistency. Within the industry, things are not that simple, and concrete mixes are designed by the engineers. Batch plants very carefully measure and weight each component, including water, prior to mixing. However, at the end of the day, it does not change the outcome. As a final product, concrete looks like jelly and flows very well. How does RCC differ from traditional concrete? RCC has two significant differences from concrete. First, there are no large rocks in the mix. Rocks are added to the mix. However, pieces of rock that are used are relatively fine. The second difference is water. RCC has almost no water in the mix, and final mix has no viscosity, which means concrete does not flow at all. As a final product, RCC looks like wet sand. Such a different consistency of RCC material requires a completely different placement method. Roller compacted concrete is mixed by a mobile plant that is deployed right at the job site. Since RCC has no viscosity, it is not transported in traditional concrete mixers. Instead, RCC is transported in dump trucks. Placement of RCC is usually done in two layers, which are called bottom and top lift. Lifts are placed by pavers that look like a typical asphalt pavers. This whole process sort of looks like asphalt placement, however, those pavers are not that simple. Pavers are equipped with special tampers that compact RCC to at least 90% of its density right at the placement. Leading paver places bottom layer of the RCC. Paver receives concrete directly from dump trucks that dumps RCC into paver's hopper. Heavy roller follows leading paver. Its purpose is to further compact RCC to 100% of its density. This is where the name comes from. As concrete is placed, it is compacted by rollers, so it is called roller compacted concrete. The second paver follows about 100 feet behind and places the second lift on the top of the first lift. Since RCC has no viscosity and it is compacted to 100% of its density, equipment can walk on RCC's surface right after placement with no issues. Unlike traditional concrete that stays liquid and then soft for an extended duration of time. The second paver cannot receive concrete from dump trucks since it is blocked by the leading paver. So instead, RCC is moved into its hopper by a conveyor. Entire pavement train slowly moves together as RCC is being placed. If RCC is placed in one lift, it just makes operation much simpler. In some cases, when the finish needs to be smooth, a troller can be utilized, but it does not happen often. Finally, a bobcat usually runs around, picking up RCC that was dropped by trucks or conveyor feeder. Curing compound is sprayed on the surface of the top lift after roller finishes compaction. It prevents evaporation of water from concrete. Pavers are guided by lasers along pre-established lane line. Placed material is frequently tested to verify its density and moisture content. The RCC paving process is extremely quick and efficient. In one day, pavers can easily place 1200 foot of 18 inch deep and 30 foot wide lane, which is an insane production rate. Even though RCC can withstand significant loads, it does require extensive preparation of the subgrade. However, it is fair to note that subgrade preparation is the same for both RCC and traditional heavy-duty concrete. The bottom line is simple: subgrade needs to be able to carry designed load, and it doesn't matter what concrete is used on the top of it. I have a separate detailed video of how subgrade is prepared for placement of 18-inch thick concrete for the container yard. Check it out if you don't know how subgrade is prepared. Link is in description. Let us quickly look at the cross-sectional drawing of the subgrade. At the very bottom, we have 8 inches of lime cement treated soil. On the top of it, we have a geotech style layer and then 4 inches of drainage rock. Next is 12 inches of cement treated base, to follow a bond breaker and 18 inches of concrete, which is placed in 2 layers of 9 inches. As subgrade is prepared, a traditional concrete requires installation of the formwork, reinforcement and joints, none of which are required for RCC. This is a huge game changer, since such preparation is expensive and labor intensive. Cutting formwork, reinforcement and joints out of the equation saves huge amount of budget and significantly increases placement rate. So why all that is unnecessary for RCC? The main objective of the formwork is to keep concrete from floating away, since its natural form is jelly and it flows well. As we know, RCC has no viscosity. As a result, formwork is not needed. The main objective of reinforcement in pavement is to control cracks. Cracks appear in a concrete during its shrinkage, as it dries and cures and changes its volume. But RCC is compacted to 100% of its density and has very low water content. So it does not really shrink and does not form excessive cracks. Hence, unlike traditional concrete, reinforcement is not needed. It would be fair to note that RCC does form minor cracks, but those cracks do not present any danger to its integrity. The main objective of the expansion joints is to allow concrete to move as it changes its volume during ambient temperature change. However, such volume change occurs primarily due to the rock that changes its volume in the body of the concrete. RCC does not have large rocks in its body and almost changes no volume with ambient temperature change, so expansion joints are not needed for RCC. Besides those benefits, RCC also offers several other benefits. Very high compressive strengths, excellent load transfer over cracks or cold joint lines, almost immediate readiness for the traffic, and finally, RCC performs extremely well under freezing conditions. So, where does RCC come from? The first experiments with concrete were conducted in the early 1930s, when engineers started utilizing concrete for pavement and roadway construction. At that time, pavement operations with concrete were expensive and time-consuming, so the goal of the experiments was to find more economical mix and to decrease placement time. But there is not much information about early research, and applications of the RCC were very scattered. RCC got real traction in the 1970s, when Canadian logging companies started widely utilizing RCC to pave their laydown areas, where logs were stored. RCC turned out to be much cheaper, ignorant to frost conditions, and extremely fast in placement. After such success, American Corps of Engineers started its own research of relatively new technology, and conducted experiments and studies in 1980s and in 1990s. Since the early 2000s, RCC applications and usage started growing drastically, and today it is a very common go-to material for heavy-duty applications, such as container yards, busy highways, airport runways, and storage areas. Another side application that was found for RCC is dam construction. There are quite a few dams all around the world that are being built with RCC, and dam construction exploded in the early 2000s. New RCC dams are being constructed all over the world. If you like construction and engineering how-to videos, don't forget to hit like and subscribe buttons.